Hello, Spider Peeps. All right, this is what I'm going to play with today. This is a little NFC tag reader. And you've probably seen these. This is like my work pass that you have. You can program these little cards up and there can be door entry systems, or there's another one in here, little tags so you can get into places. And this is what reads them. But actually, I'm playing this today because of a project called OpenSpool. A guy's created a method of reading and writing, I think, tags that go on spools so that you can theoretically make them compatible with the AMS on the Bamboo Labs printer, or use them on another printer as well, using one of these Wemos D1s. However, the one I've got is the wrong one. This is the original Wemos D1, and I think you need the version 3 of it. So I've got some of those on order from Ali. I've put a link in the description below. But if you go to the hardware section on this, it's pretty cool. It's got a little 3D thing to print out, and there's something there that goes in the AMS, which, yeah, who knows what's happening there. Let's go to the GitHub for this. So if I scroll down and look at the docs, that's a way of using it, the way someone's done it. Not sure what printer that is. Oh, that's the Bamboo one as well. Anyway, scroll down and there's a bit about the hardware on this. Yeah, so these are the things that you need. I've got one of these teeny little level shifter boards, and I'm going to hopefully harvest some of the components off that if I can do it. We need the PCB. We need some tags. Well, I've got the tags. Well, so I've got some tags there. I've also got these tags which I've been saving, which come off used spools of the Bamboo filament. I'm going to see whether I can reprogram these. And this bit we haven't got. This is the PCB. Okay, so this video is sponsored by JLC PCB. So let's go and order some of these boards from them. So I think somewhere on the GitHub, if we go to hardware and OpenSpool Mini, I think it is OpenSpool Mini version 3.1, there's the Gerber. So let's just download that. I think if you click on it, it doesn't let you download it, so we can download it there. Okay, so let's go to JLC PCB. Notice when you go to JLC PCB, there's always a coupons there. That's a good thing to look for, because you might find something. Look, PCB coupon there. That's for a 6-layer one. But sometimes there's a thing on there that's, there'll be a coupon on there that's pretty good for you to use. All right, so I'm going to sign in. Okay, so I'll click on order now. And then just click on add Gerber file. And here's the Gerber file that I just downloaded. So let's open that. Some spoilers as to my other videos there. Hope we didn't see that. All right, so that's the Gerber file uploaded and the PCB there. So watch how easy it is to order one of these. So because I'm SpiderMaf, I have to make it purple. So let's change the board to purple, which can on occasions change the delivery time of it, or the build time of it. There, but anyway, that's fine. So let's go down. It will give me 5 boards, which is what I want. We don't really want to change anything else, but let's just go down the bottom just to check that PCB assembly isn't turned on. We could order a PCB as well and have it assembled. So, you know, I've said about I was going to use these. Well, we could actually get them to put these on the board, but I'm not going to do it on this occasion. So let's do a save to cart, and you see it's come out $2 for that. So let's go in and view cart. So a special offer, $2. There's a little thing here. So there's a holiday at the moment on JLC PCB. So we're not going to be able to get this done until after February the 5th. But I think I'm going to be releasing this video after this anyway. So always around the Chinese New Year, there's a little bit of delay, but they do most things, so it's fine. But just like us, they deserve a holiday. The most expensive thing on this is going to be the shipping, I think. But anyway, let's go to secure checkout. Whoops, I have to just select what I want to order first. So go to secure checkout. Okay, so I've just scrolled down a little bit after that because my address was on the screen. Shipping estimate, $1.50, $2. So $4.20 for this. So if you get it shipped by Global Standard Direct Line, this is the cheapest way to get it. And it doesn't actually take that long to arrive, at least in the UK anyway. So $4.20. So in UK figures, that'll be much less than that. Well, that'll be a little bit less than that, maybe about £2.50, £2.80. And then we just hit continue. And there's another little thing. You can pay before or you can wait for the review. Now, as someone else has designed this PCB, probably it's going to be designed okay. So we don't need to worry about that. So we just pay first. So we will do submit order and it will take me to PayPal and we'll get that paid. And we'll wait a few weeks. Couple of weeks and it should be with me. So you see, really easy to order from JLC PCB, and for little PCB sets like this you get 5 of them. Maybe you can sell the other 4 on eBay because other people might want them, but this is real cheap way of getting PCBs, which is why they're my channel sponsor, because I use them loads. So I noticed on the website they don't have any instructions on how to create this, so I wanted to get hold of this the STL for this, and they've not released them yet, and they've also not released any information about how to build the PCB up. So I'm just doing this video. Let's see whether it will work. Let's see whether I can try and work out what's needed to get this all working with the PCB that Spuder, clever guy, has designed this. Let's see about making it anyway. Okay, so this PCB, has it arrived yet? Of course it has, I've already ordered it. Let's have a look at that. Bing, there they are, look. All right, let's get one of these out. So let's just have a look at this. It's a little bit confusing. So I assume this bit here is to do with the LED. Here's where I've got to solder on the little components of this board for the level shift. And then the Wemos will go on top, I assume. And then I need to add some headers onto the underside of that to go into this reader. So I think that's got to go on the bottom. I don't think it needs to go on that way, because if I look at it closely, this first one is the clock and this is SCK, so for the clock, and the ground is about there. So I reckon if I put a header pointing out on the underside of that, I can clip that into the board. All right, another thing that I noticed about the board is that we've got to make sure that we set it to SPI. So see this, we've got a 10 and 11 there. So the 10 should be set to 0, which it is. Push it across. And then the 11 should be set to 1. So this is the 11th line. So the switch pushes across to that. And that makes sure it goes in that SPI mode there. Whoa. Well, that's a bit weird. Okay, I don't know if you saw that. That went very weird. My camera just went nuts then. I've never seen that happen before. Okay, so now let's get this soldered on. All right, so you see this has got a set of these level shifters, so we want to take off that whatever that is, transistor, might be something else, and the two resistors off the side. So I think the best thing to do is to squirt some good old flux around it just in case, and then I'm going to put this where it goes out of focus. I'm going to put this on that board there. So let's zoom out a bit. Hopefully it still works and doesn't go weird. All right, so let's heat that up. Now the best way of doing this, I think, is going to be just to hold on to the chip there, lift it up a little bit, and I'm just going to zap it, and hopefully the weight of the board will very gently pull it off. Well, as easy as that. Lovely. So that dropped on there, so that goes cold straight away. Let's try the resistor. So there's the resistor, so grab that in a similar way. Okay, that goes down easy, and let's grab the other one to the side. All right, that was easier than I thought. So I think that's it with the hot air now. All right, so I've put a little bit of flux on there, there and there to begin with. So I'm just going to put a little bit of solder on each of those pads. I think I'll get my bionic eyes on first. So I'm just adding a little bit of solder to the pad now, so a bit more flux needed on that, I think. Both of those pads over there. I'm back with my tweezers, and then I'm going to melt that pad, that solder I just put down, as I push the transistor on. Yep, I think that's done it. I've got to do the same for the minuscule resistors as well. And I'm just going to, again, light the pad one side, melt the pad one side. I think that's done it. Let's do the same thing with the other one. Hopefully we can still see this. I'm going to put the, oh, this one. that's not in the middle, but I think we can get away with it. I think what I'll do is just put a blob of solder on here and on there. And likewise on that side. So that's put them there in a rough way. Finished with my soldering iron. So I'm going to put some more flux around it. And then do hot air on it again. And the hot air should just make it seat properly on the pads. So at some point we should see this shift. May as well do all of them at the same time. I think that's done it now. I think that's just pulled right. Maybe not. There we go. And let's do these as well. And it should just pull it onto the board. This one's sticking up a little bit. There we go. And now I'll clean this. Okay, I think that's worked pretty well. So now I've got to find a header for this. That's good. So my 2040 zeros, I've got loads of these headers. That's got the right number on. So let's solder that on next. So it's got to go on the other way. So I'm going to put a bit of flux on the top because that's where I'm going to be applying it, and then pop this through. All right, there we go. And I'm just going to do the first pin. Whoa, that's a bit unfortunate. Let's try again then. Yeah, so I do the first pin and then I make sure it's all level this way. So we see that's not perfectly level. So let's just, there we go. Now I'll solder the other pins by the time I've got back. The first one will be set again. So that was pretty simple. That looks nice, doesn't it? A bit of a, I think that's just IPA there. So now we're getting close to being able to use it. Well, I've just got to wait for my proper Wemos to come. But we're nearly there. Now, the difference between this Wemos, which I noticed, which I just had in my parts bin, and the new Wemos is more pins on the outside. So there's more of the I.O. that's available on the later ones. So I'm going to have to put some double pins in there and then solder that across. But I'll wait till it arrives, and hopefully when it arrives, it might have some double pins with them. All right, I'll see you when I next have my AliExpress delivery. All right, so in the next video, hopefully my new version of the Wemos should have turned up and we'll be able to continue building this, and we'll try and flash the OpenSpool software onto this and then see what we can read. Hope you enjoyed this. As usual, subscribe if you want to see what happens next, but otherwise, bye. button. Oh, I've actually one too many pins on that, so let's just take the top pin off. Normally I can do that with my fingers, but not on this occasion. Oh, hyperspace. With a PCB that Spudger has designed. Spudder. It's not Spudder. I'll have to stop calling him Spudder. No, I'll have to stop calling him Spudger because that's so easy. Yeah, Spudder. So,